إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. يا معشر المسلمين، رحمكم الله قد ورد في الحبر أن سيد البشر وشفيع أمتي في يوم المحشر، سيد الأشراف ومتمم مكارم الأحلاك والأوصاف، سيد العرب والعجم، سيدنا محمد ابن عبد الله ابن عبد المطلب ابن هاشم ابن عبد مناف. أنه قال سعيد الخطيب على المنبر ثم خطب: فلا يتكلم أحدكم ومن تكلم فقد لغى ومن لغى فلا ثواب جمعتنا. أنصتوا رحمكم الله فاستمعوا، غفر الله لنا ولكم ولوالدينا ولوالديكم ولأستاذينا ولأستاذيكم ولجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات، فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله، الحمد لله وكفى، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ومولانا رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه وعباد الله الذين اصطفى. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. الحمد لله. The Habib Sufi Masjid is very honored to welcome for this Jumu'ah program our esteemed guest, Sayyid Sheikh Muhammad ibn Yahya al-Nanawi hafidhahullah ta'ala. We welcome the Sheikh back to the shores of Cape Town and South Africa. The Sheikh will be in South Africa for a few days, inshallah. We'd like to thank and welcome Sheikh Nanawi as well as the Medina Institute for honoring us with this opportunity. Sheikh Nanawi will deliver the pre-khutbah talk, the Arabic khutbah, and lead us in the salah, inshallah. We trust that everyone will benefit from the Sheikh's knowledge, inshallah. Before we hand over, just a reminder, brothers, please donate generously towards the maintenance of the masjid. There is still space downstairs. Please fill the masjid from the front, especially the males. And the upstairs section on the right-hand side is reserved for the females. Jazakumullah wa khairul jaza. Without any further delay, I'll now hand over to our respected Sheikh Nanawi for the tafaddal mashkura. Nari takbir, nari risala.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأكمل التسليم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد سيد الأولين والآخرين وحبيب رب العالمين، وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وأصحابه وأزواجه وذرياته والتابعين، وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وعملا وفهما في الدين. أما بعد، مولانا شيخنا سيدي قطب الدين قاضي حفظه الله تعالى ودامت بركاتهم الحاضرين الكرام، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Gives me obviously, I'm very honored and privileged to stand in front of you here today, but also mostly in front of our own Sheikh, Sayyid Sheikh Qutb al-Din. Allah Ta'ala grant him long life with health and iman. And all of you as well, in these days that are blessed, the days of Rajab, and after Rajab comes Sha'ban, and after Sha'ban comes Ramadan. May Allah enable us to witness Ramadan and for Ramadan to be a witness for us. The best we start is Kitabullah. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Ala inna awliya Allah la khawfun alayhim wa la hum yahzanun alladhina amanu wa kanu yattaqun. Indeed, the awliya of Allah, there is no fear on them, nor shall sadness ever befall them. This concept of awliya of Allah has been an issue in the old days and in today's. And oftentimes people misunderstand the whole concept. As Al-Busiri rahimahullah in his Burda says, قَدْ تُنْكِرُ الْعَيْنُ ضَوْءَ الشَّمْسِ مِنْ رَمَدٍ وَيُنْكِرُ الْفَمُ طَعْمَ الْمَاءِ مِنْ سَقَمِ. The eye may deny the sunlight, not because the light doesn't emit sun, but because the light, the eye has an issue. And the mouth may deny the sweet taste of water, not because the water is not sweet, but the mouth has got issues. We call that veils, hijab. Kalla. إِنَّهُمْ عَنْ رَبِّهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَمَحْجُوبُونَ. They are veiled from their Lord. Not their Lord is veiled. Nothing veils the Creator. The creation is veiled from seeing their Lord. And therefore, Al-Quran gives us this sequence, if you were to say, and tells us that blindness in the Quran, not to optometrists. Now you'll see some optometrists objecting. But blindness in the Quran has nothing to do with the eyes seeing or not. Blindness in the Quran has to do with the heart seeing or not. Hence, Al-Quran moves to state in a way that those whose eyes don't see but heart see are the seeing, and those whose eyes see but heart doesn't see are the blind. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنها لا تعمل أبصار. The eyes are not blind. They see right, left, and center. The problem is they see too much. What do I mean by they see too much? They capture too much images of the creation, bringing it all to the storage in their heart, hence leaving no place in their heart to be in the presence of the Creator. It veils them from that closeness and proximity. They only see the creation. They talk about the creation. The images in their mind are the images of the creation, be it people, possessions, and things. And therefore, the Sufi have always said, فَرَّغْ قَلْبَكَ مِنَ الْأَغْيَارِ يَمْلَأْهُ بِالْمَعَارِفِ وَالْأَسْرَارِ. If you want to really see, you have to empty your heart from everything other than Him. Well, after all, If you have found him, what have you lost? And if you did not find him still, what have you gained? So this, so we can, we need to sort of synchronize, if you were to say, the Quranic terms with our usage of terms. Blind is what? Al-Quran says, إِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَلْ أَبْصَارِ. The eyes are not blind. They actually see. They see. They capture images. Capture, 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 huh? And you all know the hungry eye, I always say, the hungry eye will never have enough more. There is no more enough for the hungry eye. The only enough for the hungry eye is the sand. Once it's buried. That's the only enough. There's no more. Hungry. The eye is hungry. The reason the eye is hungry, because the eye seeks to quench its hunger and thirst by capturing more creation. But creation is ajiz. Creation is helpless. Creation in and of itself is hopeless. The only way you can get hope and illumination is through the Creator, not the creation. That fills. Then the eye is no longer hungry. It's satisfied. Allah tells us this about the satisfaction in the Quran. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alaysa Allahu bikafin abda? Isn't Allah enough for his abd? Ya salam. Isn't Allah enough? It's a question here. Ya Allah, definitely, Ya Rab, enough. How can I say otherwise? But then as if the Quran putting it in question, asking, how come some people are not finding that satisfactory? Is because they are not really abda. They are not his slaves in the practical sense. They're slaves of the images they keep capturing and they keep seeking. Sometimes Allah Azza wa Jal names people, the name of people, as alama, to distinguish them. Sometimes Allah names people not as alama, but as karama, to honor them. How so? Yani, Allah Azza wa Jal speaks about Talut and Jalut, distinguishing them. This is Talut, this is Jalut. Sometimes Allah Azza wa Jal in the Quran goes beyond just simple using the name for distinguishment, uses the name not for alama, but for karama. Alaysa Allahu bikafin abda? Isn't Allah enough for his slave? Now his slave is no longer a name as alama, a distinguishing thing from distinguishment from other creation. Abdah now is a name of karama, not a name of alama. Ya ayyuhan nabi, ya ayyuhan rasul, karama. Then Al-Quran, then we said, إِنَّا لَا تَعْمَلْ أَبْصَارِ. Ya Allah, okay, the eyes are not blind. What is blind? وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَلْ قُلُوبِ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. Allah says, which means, but really what's blind are the hearts. The hearts are the blind. All right. So then what do we do? What do we do? How? So, yani, if someone is blind, blindness in the dunya of the eyes may deprive you from capturing the images of the creation while you live in this dimension. But it will never prevent you from being close to Allah Azza wa Jal while you're still in this dimension. One of our shuyukh in Al-Azhar, Allah have mercy on his soul, he became blind. He lost his eyesight. Yani, in his early days, he lost it. And one of the strangest moments I remember him saying is, I thank Allah Azza wa Jal for taking away my eyes so I don't see anything other than him. Huh? We say, what do we say about Salatul Layl? Huh? Salatul Layl is a madrasa, right? Those of you who haven't, I mean by madrasa, school. Huh? Salatul Layl is a school in and of itself. You will know those who are refined from those who are unrefined based on whether they do the salah at night or they at night. The at night, he's seeing in the dreams the biryanis are coming and the snook and all the stuff is coming after he wakes up. And the one who is schooled in Qiyamul Layl at night, schooled, is being refined. The Qiyam of, I always say, the Qiyam itself is a school. And it's a distinguishing, because this school has definitive results. This is no more now speculative results. Everyone who signs up for the school is guaranteed passing and success. Just by mere signing. Yani no test, no test. You sign up for it, you pass. Allahu Akbar. Huh? Madrasa, school. Other schools, you sign up for it. You have to buy the books. You have to study. You have to take the tests. The whole thing in the madrasa of Qiyamul Layl, of standing up and praying at night before Fajr, Allah made it so that merely signing up for the school and standing and praying there, you are guaranteed success and refinement. You will pass. قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا كَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ. Allah calls, Allah describes his awliya. How were their awliya, ya Allah? The Quran tells us, they used to sleep, يَهْجَعُونَ, they used to sleep, but their sleep was qaleel, little. At night, night sleep was qaleel. What are they doing during the night? They're doing tasbih and takbir and hamd and Quran and salah. And that's when the hadaya, the hadiyah are, there's hadiyah. Hadayas are distributed. Huh? You stand up, here, here's your hadiyah today. Here's your hadiyah tomorrow. Here's your hadiyah. And the hadiyah from Allah is not like the hadiyah from the creation. The creation, when they give you hadiyah, they count. Allah Azza wa Jal gives countlessly. The hadiyah of the creation has limited usage and validity. There's an expiration date. The hadiyah from Allah has no expiration date. ألا إنها لا عفوا إنها لا تعمل أبصار ولكن تعمل القلوب التي في الصدور. Then how do ya Allah, how are we able then to promote or not train ourselves to have a vision of the heart rather than just vision of the eyes? I don't want you to be zahid or يعني detached from the vision of the eyes. No, may Allah keep all your vision and all your health on you. لكن may Allah help us not to use what He gives us to disobey Him. May Allah help us all not to use what He grants us to disobey Him. If you want to disobey Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, go use things He didn't give you and to a land He doesn't own. Find that if you can. How do we then move to the vision of the heart? Because blindness in the dunya is a problem. Blindness in the dunya is a problem. Blindness in the akhirah is much more problematic than blindness in the dunya. Allah says, في القرآن الكريم, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, وَمَنْ كَانَ فِي هَذِهِ أَعْمَى فهو في الآخرة أعمى وأضل سبيلا. Whoever is blind in this dunya by heart will be much more blind in the akhirah. Why? Well, because the mashayikh have always said there's a jannah on this earth. If you don't enter it, you're not entering the next one. Jannah starts right here. If you don't enter it, how will you enter the one next? The jannah is right here, and being conscientious of Allah Azza wa Jal. And in Islam, we don't have dying for the path of Allah as much. That's the easy part. It's living for the path of Allah. That's the difficult one. قُلْ إِنَّ حَيَاتِي. Right? Allah, the Quran came to speaks about نُسُكِي وحياتي ومماتي وall this. What is the whole point in all that? The whole point is that dying for the path of Allah is one thing, but living for the path of Allah is a whole another thing. Okay. من كان في هذه أمة فهو في الآخرة أمة وسد وضلوا سبيلا. What do we do, Ya Allah? Then how do we have, how do we cultivate this vision of the eyes and vision of the hearts together so we can see things better in a way? Al-Quran al-Kareem leads us to the way of Sayyidina Ibrahim al-Khalil salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. You cannot have a blind heart. You have to have a qalb, a heart that is saleem. Saleem means healthy heart, right? First it says blind heart is the problem. Now it says what kind of heart on Sayyidina Ibrahim? وَإِنَّ مِنْ شِيَعَتِهِ لَإِبْرَاهِيمِ إِذْ جَاءَ رَبَّهُ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. If you want to find success, find the success of Ibrahim, find the way of Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام. For Ibrahim has قلب سليم. And notice Ibrahim al-Khalil صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وآله is always central when it comes to Tawheed. He was the hero of Tawheed for Quran al-Kareem. Huh? From the beginning, he was fata. When he, remember when he broke the idols? What did the mushrikeen say? Inna sami'na fata. Fata doesn't mean sabi. Sabi means boy. Fata is not boy. No. Fata doesn't mean just a male. Fata comes from futuwa, chivalrous. Someone who is principled. He's not just a young man. Fata, not sabi, not walad. No. Fata from futuwa. That's a chivalrous, principled, noble young man. Mountains may move, but Ibrahim will not move. Inna sami'na fatan yadhkuruhum. We've heard about a chivalrous young man, principled, that's talking about them. That's why when Allah speaks about the people of the cave, He doesn't say, innahum sibyatun amanu bi rabbihim wazidnahum huda. He doesn't say, innahum awlad amanu bi rabbihim wazidnahum huda. No. For them, for those young people to take these steps of iman and become awliya of Allah, chivalry is required. Sacrifice is required. Love is required. And even suffering is required. That's why Allah says, innahum fityatun amanu bi rabbihim wazidnahum huda. Those are fitya. Those are young, chivalrous, principled young men. They're not just your young men. Because the value of the human being is not how many years you've grown, but have you really grown? So notice Allah Azza wa Jal tells us what the path of Ibrahim. Sayyidun al-Khalil alayhi salatu wasalam, don't think that he's yani detached from Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No. He's very central in a way, because the central is Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why we say in the Sigha al-Ibrahimiyya, right? I don't say Salawat Ibrahim. Sigha al-Ibrahimiyya. What do we say? Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى الله أكبر. How come why يعني why محمد وآل محمد why إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم. Now what's the center؟ اللهم صلي على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم. What's the center that's connecting آل who's آل إبراهيم؟ آل إبراهيم are محمد وآل محمد correct صلى الله عليه وسلم. So now you have إبراهيم محمد and آل محمد. Who's the center between all of them when you're saying اللهم صلي على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم. محمد رسول الله. You're saying يا الله give your salah and salam on Muhammad and his ancestors إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم and give your salam on Muhammad and his progeny محمد وآل محمد. محمد being the center, his ancestors and those who are off of him صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. يعني the whole صلوات, the whole صيغة الإبراهيمية, you are revolving around محمد رسول الله with his ancestors and parents and with his offspring. وإن من شيعته إلى إبراهيم إذ جاء ربه بقلب سليم. All right, then what do, ya Allah? The way of Sayyidina al-Khalil alayhi salatu wassalam, the way of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is the way that was al-Jalis, as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, al-Jalis al-Salih, and he's the best of Jalis. Jalis means company. In English, I think they say, tell me who you accompany, I tell you who you are. So why do we love the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum ajma'in? Who did you accompany? I tell you who you are. You accompanied Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I know who you are. Who your company is will influence you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us about what? Tells us about the good company and the bad company. Good company are that like the one who sells fragrances. And bad company is like the one, the blacksmith. You go and you work and you're going to all turn, you know, with all the things that the blacksmith gives. Not to belittle the blacksmith as a career. We honor the hand that works. Islam honors that hand that sweats. Islam is not a culture based on robbery and where might makes right. Where you ransack the wealth of others. No, 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 no. That was before Islam. Islam came to change the mentality of Quraysh. That honor is that sweat that comes off of that working man. That's an honorable and halal. And in halal, there is barakah, even if it's little. And in haram, there is no barakah, even if it's a lot. The awliya of Allah are those who try to what? Develop qalb salim, a heart that sees. And so long you are close to them, then you might actually have a heart that sees. The awliya of Allah, like we are still in the remembrance of Sayyiduna Mu'inuddin Chishti radiyallahu ta'ala anhu wa rahimahullah 800 years ago. Still giving. It's still a source of giving because the awliya are connected to the anbiya. And the anbiya source keeps giving. How can a prophetic source ever be dry? The prophetic source is always on giving. And amongst the givings of the prophets are the awliya of Allah. There, that's their giving. And hence Allah asks us in two ways. Number one, intellectually, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask the people of knowledge if you don't know. And in walking, Allah asks us to also follow. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وَاتَّبِعْ سَبِيلَ مَنْ أَنَابَ إِلَيْهِ. Follow the path of those who have journeyed to me. As a command, follow the path. So today, let me finish with this. Like Ibn Ata said, لا تصحبن من لا يهدك حاله ويدلك على الله مقاله. Actually, it's a portion of a weak hadith there. لكن what does it mean? Do not accompany those whose حال do not elevate you and whose مقال, حال means state, whose state do not elevate you and whose talk do not bring you close to Allah. You're wasting your time. Then how do you know the awliya of Allah? الَّذِينَ إِذَا غَابُوا افْتُقِدُوا. The weak hadith mentions. Those when they are absent, they are missed. وَإِذَا حَضَرُوا ذُكِرَ اللَّهِ. And when they come, Allah is mentioned. Not the dunya. How do you know the awliya of the dunya? Whenever their present, dunya is mentioned. How do you know the awliya of Allah? Whenever their present, Allah is mentioned. So I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us all amongst His awliya and to make us amongst those who love His awliya, because it's sunnah to love the awliya of Allah. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in hadith Tirmidhi himself says, Ya Allah, as'aluka hubbak wa hubba ma yuhibbuk. I ask you to grant me your love and the love of those who love you. Loving those who love you, that's a sunnah by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imagine for us, Ya Allah, grant us the love of you and the love of those who love you and the love of deeds that are beloved to you. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa alihi walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
جزاكم الله خير الجزاء. To our respected Sheikh Muhammad bin Yahya An-Nawawi for his inspirational and enlightening talk, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all the hidayah and tawfiq. Ameen. Now just the following announcements, so please bear with me. The Chachi Sharif Wisal Khatam of Hazrat Khwaja Khwajaghan, Hazrat Khwaja Mu'inuddin Chisti Qaddasallahu Sirrahu Al-Aziz, will be commemorated this evening in the Mazar Sharif. Program will be Maghrib Salah, Khatmi Khwajaghan, Kira'a, Naat, Qasida, Qasaid, Lecture, Sandal, Salami, and Dua. The program will be hosted by our respected ulama of the CTIEC in organization, inshallah. Isha Salah will be thereafter, followed by a Mahfil Isama in the Mazar. Ladies' accommodation will be provided. All are welcome. The event will be streamed on both YouTube and Facebook. And then also the Urush Sharif of Hazrat Khwaja Gharib Nawaz, Qaddasallahu Sirrahu Al-Aziz, and Hazrat Mawla Abdul Latif Qadi Siddiqui Chisti Nizami, Qaddasallahu Sirrahu Al-Aziz, the co-founder of this masjid, will be commemorated here next weekend from the 2nd until the 5th of February, inshallah. Please see the notices and the online media and website. Just a reminder that the guest for the Urus program next weekend will be our respected Mawla Mukhti Muhammad Farooq Sufi of the Azhar Sufi Sahabat Shabir Dabal, Riverside, Kenville, Durban, our respected Natha Hafiz Rashid Qazi, as well as the Mahfil Isama group, Ijaz Sabri and Party. All are welcome. Special accommodation will be provided for ladies. Shukran. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين. ربي احمل لنا بالخير برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. والحمد لله رب العالمين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة
الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره نستعين به جل وعلا نستهديه ونستغفره نعوذ به جل وعلا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا شيء قبله ولا شيء بعده مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا وإمامنا وقدوتنا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف بإذن ربه الغمة وعبد الله ربه حتى أتاه اليقين صل اللهم وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله في كل آن وحين وارض اللهم عن أزواجه وأصحابه وأحبابه والتابعين وعن ولا سيما الخلفاء الراشدون والأئمة المهديون ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن عميه الشريفين الحمزة والعباس وعن الحسن والحسين وفاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين وعن سائر الصحابة والأهل والقرابة ومن اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد عباد الله أنصحكم ونفسي الآثمة بتقوى الله أحثكم وإياها على طاعته أحذركم وإياها وبال مخالفته ومعصيته قال رب العالمين بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب وقال نبينا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم أنا أعلمكم بالله وأخشاكم له صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وأزواجه أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه يغفر لكم
اللهم احتن لنا بالحين إلهي بحرمة القرآن العظيم والنبي الكريم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ما اتصلت عين بنظر وسمعت أذن بخبر، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم الشفيع المشفع في المحشر. صلى اللهم عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وأحبابه وأتباعه دائما أبدا سرمدا يا رب العالمين. عباد الله، اتقوا الله العظيم حق تقواه، راقبوه مراقبة من يعلم ويعتقد بأنه يراه. تزودوا من دنياكم لآخرتكم عملا يحبه ويرضاه. اعلموا أنه لا يضر وينفع، ويعطي ويمنع، ويصل ويقطع، ويخفض ويرفع إلا الله. واعلموا أن الله تعالى أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه، قال تعالى ولم يزل قائلا عليما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، أعلي مولانا كلمة الحق والدين. اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيراً فوفقه إليه، من أراد به بهم غير ذلك فهده يا ربنا سواء السبيل. آتي أنفسنا تقواها، زكها أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. اشف اللهم مرضانا، عاف مبتلانا، فك أسرانا، ارحم موتانا، اغفر اللهم لنا ولوالدينا ومشايخنا ومن له حق علينا، ولمن على الخير أعاننا ومن عن الشر أبعدنا، ولمن أوصانا بالدعاء، ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك يا ربنا سميع قريب مجيب للدعوات. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله. أقيم الصلاة.
Please fold the caps, brothers, please fold the caps and fold the mercy from the front. Please straighten the softs.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
لا إله إلا الله، سيدنا محمد رسول الله. استووا واستقيموا إلى الصلاة. يرحمني ويرحمكم الله. الله أكبر، وجهت وجهي للذي فطر السماوات والأرض ومن صلاتي ومسكي معي. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. إن الذين كفروا سواء سواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. ختم الله على قلوبهم وعلى سمعهم وعلى أبصارهم غشاوة ولهم عذاب عظيم. ومن الناس من يقول آمنا يقول آمنا بالله وباليوم الآخر وما هم بمؤمنين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. يوفون بالنذر ويخافون يوما كان شره مستطيرا ويطعمون الطعام على حبه
مسكينا ويتيما وأسيرا إنما نطعمكم لوجه الله لا نريد منكم جزاء ولا شكورا. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله العظيم والتواب الرحيم الذي لا إله إلا هو. نتوب إليك ونسألك توبة ومغفرة وهداة لنا فإنك أنت التواب الرحيم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام وإليك يعود السلام. فحينا ربنا بالسلام وادخلنا الجنة برحمتك دارك دار السلام. تباركت ربنا وتعاليت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. تقبل الله منا منكم. جمعة مباركة to everyone إن شاء الله. شكرا.